Okay, Mr. T's gonna... I was standing here by the trailer, and this plastic bag blew out. And because it blew out, it kind of scared him a little bit. Because he was tied up to the trailer. And you see he's at the end of his rope. Hence the old saying, I'm at the end of my rope. Another horse saying that people have said for years. Meaning that if you reach the end of the rope, you're about to blow up. So leave me alone. So the old... People hear all kind of horse sayings out there. They never know they came from the horse. I mention a lot of those, I think, on my horse history page. But anyway, Tanner was at the end of his rope, so I was like, okay, he's telling me he needs to be sacked out. A lot of people don't want to sack out enough, and I'm a big sack out. A lot of my tapes are about sack. Oh, man, there's a good... Oh, that's great. There's a fly there. Oh, shoot, it went away. Big old horse fly. I've been wanting to do a video on how to kill those things, and I can't find them too much. Darn. It's too bad. So anyway, we're going to go back to sacking out, and we're going to go to how to kill a horse fly. I'll get to that later. So anyway, a lot of sayings out there. Tanner was at the end of his rope, so I said, okay, he's telling me that he needs to be sacked out. He's telling me that, you know what, I haven't desensitized him enough lately because this bag scared him, and since I got a reaction, I didn't like that. Now, what a lot of people do is hide the bag, move the bag, put the bag away, keep bags away. Okay, a lot of things that I tell people to do with horses is the opposite of what you think. If you look at most people who aren't horse savvy, whatever they do is the opposite. Why? Because they think like a predator. They think like a human. They think like they're, you know, they have no fear because they're at the top of the food chain. And that's usually opposite of what you do for a horse who is at the bottom of the food chain. They get eaten by just about anybody or anything. And their only defense is to run and their speed. So whatever you want to do to a horse, normally, if it doesn't work, you need to do the opposite. Or whatever your instinct says, I want to do, do the opposite. Because a horse is opposite from us. I'm going to go ahead and do some little advanced sacking out here. Big T knows what this bag is. He shouldn't be moving. I'm going to get on his head while I'm wagging this around so you can tell. His ears are back. He's watching. He's standing stiff. I can tell by his body that he's not totally relaxed, but you know what? He's not moving. And as long as he doesn't move, I'm okay with that. And then I'm going to come to the front, see if I can get him to the end of his rope. Rub that over his eyes and ears. He did okay. Rub it over the eyes and ears. A lot of times I'll stand out here and I'll chase flies with this plastic bag. While my horse is eating or doing something, I'll just sit out here and when the flies get on his feet, I'll just move around and get the flies off him. Let him know this plastic bag is his friend. And then after I do all this, of course, horse always has two sides, so we got to do both sides. For the sake of this video, I'll go quickly here on the other side. Get his legs, get under his belly, get between his legs, between his front legs, under his belly. There's some flies there. Let me get these flies. Come back up to his head. Poor Mr. T. I'm such a mean dad. I know I don't love you. I don't love you because I make you do things that you don't want to do. Therefore, I can't love you. If I loved you, I'd just give you carrots and let you do whatever you wanted and be dangerous and kill people. But since I don't love you, I'll make you do things you don't want to do. And then we're going to go to a paper bag. And you saw Mr. T. When I pulled this out, watch Mr. T. I'm going to make this horse react. Look at that. I made that horse. I scared that freaking horse. That was my fault, and I shouldn't have done that. And I did it for your benefit because a horse is only a reflection of what we do. If I bring this horse up gently and present it to him, he doesn't freak out. But if I sit here and let him relax and then what I do what I call ambush a horse and just do this, he gets scared. He's not scared because he's stupid. He's scared because I'm stupid. I'm the one that made that horse get scared. I'm making this horse scared. I'm putting too much pressure. I'm not reading my horse and saying, hey, I'm putting him at the end of his rope. Give him a break. I'm sorry, Mr. T. I know. You're a good boy. So I'm going to use some feel here and get him to walk on in. Come here, bud. Come. I know. I know. Head. Good boy. Hear those nostrils? Those nostrils are big and he's scared. This is where the original sacking out came from. It's a sack. And if I went up to him when it was fully open, it would be too big. So I'm going to make it half the size and I folded it in half. And I'm going to make it even smaller and fold it in half again. So now it's nice and small. And I'm going to start rubbing him with this gently because I got him a little jacked up. And see, he's flinching and he's nervous and he's watching. He's like, you know what? I'm not sure about that bag. You just scared me with it. Because you're a stupid human, and you didn't set me up for success, and you shook it too fast, and you scared me, so now I don't know if I can trust you. because you didn't talk to me. You didn't present this. I made this horse scared. I made him fearful as a bag because of what I did. And that's why I get so irritated with people when it's like, my stupid horse, that's stupid. I don't know what's wrong with it. Your horse is doing it because you're doing it wrong. If you do it right, your horse will do it right. If I present this to Tanner and let him smell it and let him know that it's not going to hurt him and then rub it on his head and rub it around his eye, he knows it's not going to hurt him because I'm doing it softly. I'm presenting it in a way that he can handle it. I'm reading his fears. And when people sack people out, it's always about just shake it in their face. Oh, my God, I'm going to scare him. Look at that. Oh, my God, look at that crazy horse. He just scared. Oh, my God, I got him at his end of his rope. And then they wonder why the horse is scared. They wonder why their horse don't trust him. I know, Big T. I'm sorry. So I got Tanner all jacked up. And again, the good thing about horses, you can screw them up fast. You can fix them pretty fast. That's why when people go, oh, this horse, he's been doing it for 3 years and he was abused and I can't fix it. And you know what? You can't fix it because you're doing it wrong. A horse can be fixed just as quick as he can be messed up. So I got Tanner jacked up on his bag. I've got to do some desensitizing because what I did was sensitize him. Same thing I do with my body when I'm working him. I can be small and mellow and ask nicely, or I can get mean, bad, and make him say, you know what, I better not mess with Dad. I better move. You know, if all I did was ask him, oh, please, Mr. T, can you please lunch for me pretty and nice? He'd be like, screw you. But I have to be able to, and he has to know that I will enforce it and I will make him do something. He doesn't want this paper bag on him, and I've kind of spooked him with it. But you know what? He ain't got no choice. He's got to stand here. I've got to rub it. I've got to rub it underneath him. I got to rub it on his belly. He's going to be nervous. He's a little worried about it, but that's okay. Because he knows that we've done this a lot of times, and he's not supposed to be running and moving from me. So I'm going to move these flies away. So this is so I went from a plastic bag to a paper bag. And again, the old feed sack that I was just using is how the term sacking out came from. And now I'm going to go to a chair. And again, this is advanced sacking out to where I want my horse everything. So Tanner sees that chair and he's like, oh, crap, here we go. All right, Mr. T, we're going to work on sacking out a chair. So I'm going to toss it around him a little bit. He knows it's a chair. He knows what it is. I'm going to give him a chance to smell it. I'm going to give him a chance to stand next to it. I'm going to give him a chance to maybe rub it on his nose so he knows it's not going to eat him. I'm even going to give him a chance if he wants to chew on it or nibble or bite it. He fills it. That's great. Now I'm going to set it on top of him. And he's probably going to move and go, what the? But you know what? He has to learn to accept things. Good boy. Look at that head. Good boy, Stan. I know. He's nervous. Those ears are straight back to the threat. Look at those ears. I don't know what that is. I'm scared. Look at that eye. He's really got his head cocked. This is on his back. It's putting pressure on his shoulder and it's putting pressure on his back. But you know what? That's okay. I'm going to slowly slide it off him, see what kind of reaction I get. Good boy. Good boy. And he did okay. Now I'm going to throw this back at him, let him see it's not going to hurt him, and let him stand there, and then I'm going to give him some release. Release is the key to sacking out. You have to let the horse know, if you stand still and let me do something, it's okay. I'm going to let you do it. But no matter what I use, you know, I've got my chinks in here, and I'm always wearing those, and they're always flapping around. But you know what? When I take them off, and I'm riding with him, I always throw them over his back. Let him stand there, because they flop. Just head when these things hit him. Oh, shit, what the hell is that? Now, I got those chaps hanging over him. So they're going to blow in the wind. When he moves, they're going to kind of rattle. But you know what? He needs to learn to stand and accept things when I do to him. I put a saddle on him. I get on top of him. I want this horse as safe as I can make him. So I'm always pushing and advancing. I'm always looking for things to sack this horse out, to make him a better horse, to see where his fear at, and can I control that fear? Can I read that fear to where it goes up and down? I'm going to go ahead and give him a little carrot and see if he'll eat. He's not too relaxed. See, he doesn't even want the carrot. He's like, all right, dude, I'll eat it, but I'm not too happy. And that's okay. And people go, oh, you're using treats to train him. No, I'm not. I'm using carrots to kind of get him to relax, to see where his mind's at, to get him to know that even though he's scared, it's okay. Bad things aren't going to happen. Of course, if I set him up to fail and I do something stupid and make him rear over and flip on his back or try to shove him in a trailer and he bangs his head, then he's like, I'm not ever trusting you again. You're an idiot. And I always get these letters and emails, my horse loved me, and then, you know, now the horse is hurt, and it's like, and I don't know what happened, he don't trust me anymore. Well, guess what? You blew it. You blew it, so you got to go out there and you got to rebuild the trust. You got to show him, you know what, even if I let you down, even if you get hurt, you still got to listen to me. You still have to, oh, I'm at 10 minutes. Well, that's Van sacking out. Got to go. Thanks, Mr. Teat.